school sports in the Fox Valley area and the only live online high school sports talk show in the state. I'm Ricardo Arguello, part of the USA Today Network Wisconsin digital live stream team. We are here in an amazing high definition at the Mothership, the Pulse Crescent, 306 West Washington Street, downtown Appleton. And this week, our focus shifts to WI State boys soccer. We are pleased to have one of the top teams in the state here on the big show from the Neenah boys soccer team. Farthest over to my right, Thomas Priest. Thomas, say hi to everyone.
Hi. There you go.
And directly to my right, let's see if I can do this right now, Andrew Nasser.
Yep.
Yes, all right. Yeah, both guys are on board to talk about the great season that they've had and their expectations heading into the state tournament over there at U-Line Soccer Park in Milwaukee. But before I start, I want to let everyone know that we are live and interactive. So if you have any questions, log into that live chat. If you're watching on a desktop or on your tablet, log into the live chat. But put your name. Don't be putting anonymous or guests. These guys want to know who's asking the questions, all right? Try to put down your real identity. I got Brett Christofferson over there holding it down behind the Dell computer who get those questions over to us right away. And don't forget about Jim Rosendick. He's punching buttons and adjusting stuff here. He's the guy who puts everything together logistically for us. But like I do before every show, and ladies, I know it's hard, but you can't be asking the guys for numbers or anything like that. You got to keep it just on soccer. So, yeah, we have to do that now. I have to put that little disclaimer ahead. Girls asking athletes for numbers and stuff like that the first couple shows we had. So always got to do that. So what I want to do is let's start with some bios, okay? So what I want you to do is let everyone know the position or positions that you play in soccer and also how you got into playing the sport. So I'm going to start farthest over to my right. Thomas, this is actually where I want you to look at the center camera.
Okay.
So go ahead again. Position or positions that you play and how you got into soccer. Go ahead.
I play forward, and I got into soccer just basically through my family. My parents, both my parents grew up playing. And then my older brother played when he was young, so I was always around it, and then just fell in love with it.
Okay, all right, Andrew, go ahead.
My parents did a good job in introducing me different sports to play as a child, and soccer I just stuck with. That's what I loved, and that's what I kept doing. I'm also a forward.
Okay, all right, good stuff. So we have the offensive guys here on the show. First off, great season that you guys have had, 17-1-3, FEA champs. Back at the state tournament. I was actually at the tournament where you guys won the state championship. I remember way back then. That's a long time ago. You guys were just kids at that point, but I remember Sergio and all those guys just having a great game and getting that championship trophy. But you guys are, in my opinion, in a great position now to do this. What I want to know is, did you expect to be in this situation, though? We're going to get to some specifics about the tournament, but did you expect, you know, to be here at this level in the Final Four, I guess, basically, you could say?
I did, because last year I think everyone knew we went out early, so they kind of gave us motivation. And we worked really hard over the summer, like everyone, and we've just been grinding the whole year, so okay. I do believe that we should be here.
Andrew, was that in the back of your mind, like Thomas said, just that not getting to where you wanted to be?
I think we thought we would be here, but I don't think anyone else did, okay, with all the seniors that have been leaving. But yeah, I think we had a good idea that we'd make it this far.
Okay, good stuff. Brett, you'll let me know. We have someone already. Okay, here we go.
Yes.
Now again, don't be putting an awesome guest. Let's see who they got. Brett, what do you have for us?
Well, we got a lot of comments.
Oh, boy.
But I'm going to ignore those. The guys can go back and read it after the show.
Okay.
But let's start with this question right away. Let's just put the guys on the spot. Sean Forget, I don't know if that's a true last name, but
Forget. It's French.
I'm not French,
okay,
obviously.
Yeah.
I'm Norwegian, but what is the key strategy against Eau Claire Memorial?
Now,
careful,
okay,
guys.
Yeah. I don't want, no. Be general, guys. I mean, because we all want you guys to bring home that championship. But yeah, general thought about it. Is it so much about what they're doing, or is it more about what you guys are doing, Andrew, out there?
I think we just got to bring our best energy. We've done it against Homestead, and we've done it against Arrowhead. And we've done it all season long, so if we do that, we'll be just fine. That's our strategy.
Yeah, I agree. Like, if we come out hard and like intimidate them in a way, then we usually find a way to win and
okay,
score early and get on them.
Now, Brett, before we go back to online, I got to ask this question: how in the heck are you guys the 3 seed? And look, I'm hopefully Todd Clark, WI, you guys are watching, and I know it's the coaches and stuff who seed you guys, but how is that possible? You guys beat Homestead, the team that beat Marquette, you know, a nationally ranked team. You guys beat Homestead. How is it that you guys are the 3 seed? That's bizarre. Doesn't make any sense at all, Andrew. Now, I know that they might be, well, you never know, you know. I know you have to answer a certain way, but we're stunned that that's the case here.
You gotta give us the credit we deserve. I don't think we've been given the credit, but we gotta beat the teams regardless, so.
Okay.
We'll do it.
Yeah. Thomas?
I definitely agree. I mean, arguably the hardest sectional we're in, and we came out of it.
So were you shocked? I mean, to be honest with you, were you guys shocked when you guys got that?
Yeah, I was a little bit.
Okay.
Yeah.
Okay.
Yeah.
Interesting stuff. Well, like you said, Andrew, you guys do have to play the teams and everybody, and you play Eau Claire Memorial. So they're the two seed. And then the other two teams, by the way, Verona and Kenosha Tremper. Verona got the one seed, right?
Mm-hmm. Yep.
So what can you tell me about Eau Claire Memorial? I mean, you guys are playing them 7 o'clock on Friday. What can you tell me about them?
I'm not really sure. We've heard they're obviously good, but... Okay.
You guys have not played them this year, though, so so it's kind of going in not knowing what they're about,
all right? Blindside, yeah.
Okay.
We've heard some of the scores of the teams that they've played that we've also played, like North. They beat 2-1 early in the season, and then 3-0 just in the past game.
Okay.
So they can play against the best teams. We're ready, though.
Is that a good thing or bad thing, not knowing who you're playing?
I think that's a good thing.
You do?
I personally think it's a good thing.
Okay, how about for you, Andrew?
I don't know. I like knowing a little bit, but
Yeah. All right, interesting stuff. Let's go back to online, Brett. What do you have for us?
They might like it from their vantage point. Eau Claire Memorial doesn't know what they're getting themselves into.
Yeah, exactly.
I have two questions from Molly Wilgreen. Am I saying that name right? The first one for the guys, how concerned are you about the conditions you'll be playing in Friday night? It's going to be very cold
and
a little slick, too, maybe.
The temperatures are about 15, 20 degrees. Cooler than they should be.
Ridiculous.
Typical November. It is getting a little ridiculous. How much does that play in effect? You guys are hardened athletes. You guys are used to playing in different weather conditions, I'm sure. But Andrew, what's that like playing in those kind of, I know both teams have to play in it, but still, it's not something optimum. You don't want to play in that kind of weather, right?
Yeah, probably not. But I think it gets more of a reputation than it needs to. Like, if you've ever been out there in the cold playing in a soccer game that's like that big of a deal, you're not going to notice it that much once you get 10 minutes into it. So.
Okay, interesting. Thomas.
Yeah, and winning, how it was that cold last weekend and winning, I think we kind of got used to it. And being outside for the past week, we're used to it. So I think it won't be as bad as people might think.
Okay, interesting. Good stuff. Brett, you have something else?
Well, now the second question from Molly is to Andrew. What does your mother think of your hair?
Nice blow, by the way. Yeah, what does she think of it?
I don't know. She doesn't like it, but...
What?
Yeah.
Really? Okay.
She tries to get me to cut it as much as possible.
Okay. When was the last time you got a good haircut?
Before the season. Way before the season.
Okay.
I don't know. I used to cut it whenever it got right below my eyes. It started getting in the way of my vision. Mm-hmm. But then I found out about the headband, and just haven't had to cut it since.
Okay. All right. There you go. Brett, you have something else?
Yes. Let's go from, is it Josh Conger or Conger?
Conger.
Conger. He wants to know, how important are the Rocket Rowdies to the success of the team?
Love the Rocket Rowdies. And a lot of the stuff, you know, for basketball, football, it always seems Neenah brings it in terms of the fan element. How do you like them Rocket Rowdies there?
Shout
out. Talking to Thomas. Yeah, you feel free to give some shout out to your boys or girls.
Shout out to Andrew Watt and Michael Kahn.
Yeah.
They do a great job. I feel like they get us kind of hyped for the games, but sometimes maybe carried away. But
okay.
I don't know.
All right.
It helps us a lot, I think.
Okay. Andrew?
A little bit. They've been bringing so much hype to Neenah soccer. Like, in the past years, it's been a lot of football, but we've got a lot of attention for soccer lately, which has been awesome.
Okay, good stuff. Did you have something else?
Let's keep it going. Ty Diaz, I want to say, speaking of Josh, wants to know how important his presence is on the bench.
The bench players, how important are they?
Oh, the bench, great, yeah, they have a great impact. They bring it every single day. They play just as hard as we do, and it's awesome.
Okay.
That's what you want from everyone. They bring energies, too.
Yeah, just going off them, they make us better every day by putting in the work, even though they might not get the time they want or the time they deserve. But, yeah, they help us get better and
All right.
better.
And giving them a little attention now, too. Let me ask you a question here, Brett. The Neenah tradition now, I've been at the Post Crescent since 2006. I know Phil well about, you know, Neenah and how, anytime I go anywhere, I bring up Neenah, immediately soccer. They think of soccer, they think of tennis, Okay, and then now lately with the Acero girl and then the diving.
Well, boys basketball has
and boys basketball has been there too.
History.
But ultimately, it to us in this area, it seems like soccer, boys soccer. You guys are the kind of the platinum program around here. Is that a good thing? You like having those kind of expectations on you? Being a, it's a prestigious program. Do you like having that kind of pressure on you?
I do. Yeah, there's been lots of historical people that have gone through the program, so to play in the same program as them is great, and keep that expectation is something I like.
Okay, okay, Andrew.
Yeah, just I remember being in middle school and there's been players that have gone through, like Adam Pullman and Evan Dujardin. They've been like my role models, like making varsity as a freshman, and that's awesome. So they just motivated me and made me want to be like them.
Before we go to Brett on another online question, can you talk about your jerseys a little bit? Is there significance with the numbers 2 and 9 here? Or was that just kind of, I just saw 2 and it fit me the jersey and that was it?
Well, freshman year, me and him kind of got last pick because we were freshmen, and 2 was the last number, so I just...
And you just decided to stay with it?
Yeah, I just decided to stay with it.
Yeah, I got lucky with 9 because that's actually a pretty good number, so I went with that.
Okay, okay.
It kind of fits the striker number 2, that's what I am now, so...
All right, good stuff. Brett, what do you have from online?
Yeah, Bryce Henderson wants to know, for the guys, how did you feel after scoring penalties against Arrowhead? Did you guys touch on that a little
good
bit?
Good question.
Yeah.
That was so scary. That was the scariest moment of my life. Yeah, not gonna lie. But it felt awesome right after we got that last penalty in, and right after, well, they unfortunately missed for them, but yeah, felt great.
It was also so rewarding because we've been working on penalty kicks basically for 2 weeks before, knowing that we had a chance of going into PKs. So then executing and shooting all 5 was really nice.
No, there's a lot of kind of sudden death situations in sports, but do you feel like that is pretty much the ultimate when you come down to it? What are your thoughts? Is that, I know you guys would rather have it taken care of in regulation or maybe in the extra time, but what's going through your mind when you're doing like, oh, we got to come down to now our goalie and our kicks and stuff like that?
Well, I'm confident in our players and goalie, so I always have confidence in everyone.
Okay.
But, yeah.
You just, there's nothing else that you can do but be confident. You just got to go up there, hit your shot. If you just worry about it too much, it's not going to end up well. So,
okay,
you got one option.
And one last thing, do you guys have a pre-order of like who's going to take the shots, or is that determined like on the field?
We have like a solid 5 that we go to.
And the mixture doesn't matter, like who goes or whatever? Or
We usually sort that out, whoever's feeling the most confident.
Yeah, I gotcha. Okay. Yeah. All right, interesting stuff. Brett, did you have something else?
Actually, I have a question myself about PKs, but... There must be a technique or a strategy, right? You're not just out there trying to bomb balls past the goalie. Explain kind of how you practice.
Now, don't
that.
Give anything away.
No, but I'm curious.
We're curious. Yeah, we're not soccer players. We don't know what goes through your mind. That's what we're looking for. What's going through your mind?
I don't know. Usually, a player has a certain shot they just practice over and over. So then you just, I don't know. There's really no technique. Some players try and fake the goalie out.
Okay.
But others just trust their shot and shoot it there.
Are you more of the latter there, trust your shot rather than fake out the goalie?
Yeah, probably trust my shot.
Okay. Yeah. All right. Interesting stuff. Good question, Brett. You don't have anything from
Well, Alexander Knight, I know you're going to ask this, Ricardo,
okay,
but to pregame traditions or rituals
yes,
for good
that's
luck?
Yes, that's fine. We can ask that one now. I'm looking for individual, and if you have a team one, I don't know. How about, do you have anything, Andrew, like that?
Not necessarily pregame, but I like to chew gum while I play. It cools me down. Calms my nerves.
Okay, interesting. So, That's good. How about for you, Thomas?
Before games, I usually just listen to music and then eat a peanut butter and jelly.
Okay. What kind of music? A little Bieber?
Yeah. No. I don't know. Some rap just to get me pumped up.
Okay. What about team aspect? Do you guys do anything as a team to get ready, or is it just kind of all every man for himself in that aspect until you got in the field?
A lot of shouting.
Pushing each other focused, around.
Interesting. Great stuff here. Brett, did you have something else?
Ethan Coons for Thomas. Who's the GOAT?
This man's the GOAT, right?
Okay. He's the GOAT.
You're looking at who the GOAT is.
Okay. Greatest of all time, Brett. That's what GOAT means.
Well, I know that.
Oh, okay. I wasn't sure you know.
But I thought
you meant a farm animal. I don't know.
Maybe there was a backstory.
All right, good stuff. You have something else, Brett, or we can go to halftime?
Josh Conger, who is the better defender, Bryce or Reed?
That's a tough one. I don't
know. Say their full name for folks out there who know.
We can talk about this one.
Bryce Henderson and Reed Sickles. So Reed's actually a first first-year player on varsity, and okay. he didn't show up to any captain's practices during the summer.
Okay.
And he just played last year.
Yeah, just shows up to tryouts, makes the team.
Okay.
He's a good player. He's a good
We
good
all
athlete.
Love him.
We
yeah.
love him, yeah. And Bryce is our rock back there, our starting center back. So
that's interesting.
Know.
Well, I want to know more about the Reed kid. I mean, so he comes in and does it. that's... You know, that's kind of like walking off the street and going and golfing, you know, or you have something
well,
else.
Well, Sean Forget about Reed said, I heard he brings the fire each and every practice and game. Is that kind of the Mr. Energy for you guys?
He has a fun time out there.
Yeah, he's just a goofball. Guy.
Okay. Yeah. That's interesting. So, now, like, all teams need, you need different characters on the team to make it work. But, man, a team that's as good as you guys, so he must be a heck of an athlete. I mean, am I right? I mean, how does he get it
he's
done?
He's a tank. Yeah, okay. he is.
All right, interesting. I'm
just
very
shows
curious
up and
about
makes
this.
A team. Yeah.
Yeah, just like, hey, guys.
It's like now he's going to state.
Yeah, that's what I'm saying. You guys are a state quarterfinalist or state semifinalist, and he's there making your team. Interesting stuff. Okay, guys, I'm going to need to take 30 seconds. All right, I got to pay the bills, do our promos. I'm going to start off with our official sponsor. That's Verlo Mattress, Factory of Appleton, Green Bay, Oshkosh, Fond du Lac, and Sturgeon Bay. Our craftsmen manufacture your bed on site with unmatched quality customer service. Stop in today for our fall mattress clearance sale. Again, that's Verlo Mattress Factory of Appleton, Green Bay, Oshkosh, Fond du Lac, and Sturgeon Bay. Now, my next promo, guy, you guys are Packer fans, right? Andrew, yeah. Thomas, you guys, I can't stand them. Bears fan here, but I co-host a Packer show with Brett Christofferson right there. Jim Rosendick does all that kind of logistic stuff at the production end of it. A running back, I was going to say Andrew Jones. It's Aaron Jones. Oh, Aaron, I hope you're not watching. Aaron Jones. See, I'm a Bears fan. I don't remember Packer guys. Heck of a player. Well, he's second in the league in touchdowns, I think.
Behind McCaffrey
of Carolina. Great guy. Our co-host. And he brings great guests. Alan Lazard. Did I say that right?
Yes.
Alan Lazard this past week. So it's a free show, guys. And it takes place right downtown Appleton here. Inside the Red Line Hotel is a clubhouse grill. Sports and Grill. Come on in every Monday, 6:30 p.m. and watch the best Packer show around. You get to see all your favorite Packers. Who's your favorite Packer, Thomas?
Aaron Rodgers.
Well, he's been on our show twice. How about for you, Andrew?
Aaron Rodgers.
Yeah, same thing. He's been on our show twice. We've had Jordy Nelson. What other guys? Devontae Adams. We've had all your big stars have been on the show at one time or another. What did you say there, Rosie?
Eddie Lacy.
Eddie Lacy. Not with the Packers anymore, but he was on our show. But yeah. Great, great time. You win great prizes and you get to meet all your favorite Packers. So please come on down every Monday, 6:30 p.m. for the best Packer show around. Are you guys on Twitter? Thomas, you are? Okay, how about for you, Andrew?
Nope,
you haven't succumbed to Twitter yet. Okay.
I'm not.
Well, Thomas, if you want to give your Twitter account, feel free to go do that.
I think it's just Thomas Priest.
Okay, at Thomas Priest.
Yeah, at Thomas Priest.
Okay, I'm at PC Ricardo. Brett's at PC Brett C. Rosie's at Metal Rosie. I love Twitter. It's my favorite social media medium because... of this, what would you say? Like immediately, I can update scores. I can immediate what's going on. Immediately, I can update what's going on in the game. Oh, my man, Andrew, he just scored another goal. You know, Thomas just completed a hat trick. It's one of those things where if I'm at the game, I can update right away. So please follow me at PC Ricardo. Podcast, we have a podcast, guys, and we're going to talk about you tomorrow on the podcast when we tape it. The podcast is the R&B show. Get it, Ricardo?
Yeah,
Brett, it's pretty slick. I know, creative. But yeah, if you have iTunes, Stitcher or Google Play, any of those three areas, go download it. The podcast is the only one dedicated to high school sports in the Foxwood area. Leave a comment, even if you don't like us, leave a comment anyway, all right? But you will like us because we're the best. What else? Live stream, Appleton North at Kimberly, Brett, right? When's that start? 6:45 p.m.
6:45.
That's right. We're doing the big Appleton North Kimberly state quarterfinal. So please check that out. That's again at Papermaker Stadium, but we'll have it on PostCrescent.com. We already talked about Twitter. Shout outs. Now, guys, this is very important. Don't forget to mention people who got you where you are today, because people get very upset when you don't mention them, I've heard. So that's just people telling me after, like, oh, I forgot to mention him. He's going to kill me. That kind of stuff. I don't want none of that. Don't get in anyone's doghouse, okay? That's for the end of the show, so start thinking about it now. All right, Brett, did you have something else from online as we start our second half?
Well, Sean Forget wants to know to you, Ricardo. He wants to know who your favorite Packer player is.
Who my favorite Packer? Does he mean like this year? Or
I don't
like
know. He's
all time? You want to know who it is?
I know who it is.
You know who it is. Who is it?
Sterling Sharp.
Sterling Sharp. That's way before your time, but I love Sterling Sharp. I wish he played for the Bears. He's just a tough-nosed receiver. He played a whole season with turf toe. Can you imagine that?
Yeah,
a whole season with turf toe. That's ridiculous. And he still led the league in touchdowns and catches. 120-something, I think he had, or 112 or something. That's incredible. But, Ben, hey, honorable mention to Brett Favre, though. I actually did like Brett Favre, even though he always killed my Bears. Do you have another question from online? No. Guys, this is a question that I wanted to ask in the first half. I didn't get to. Coach Ross, what can you tell me about him that people might not know? Maybe I'm looking for a little dirt. All right, so maybe some kind of interesting quirk that he does, guys. Anything like that? What can you tell me about him, Thomas?
He's a great guy, but he loves to run us a lot. So we like to run the hill. We have a hill at our school, so we run that a bunch for conditioning.
Wow, even this late in the season, you guys run that?
No, but we still do sprints and stuff.
Okay, interesting. Yeah. All right, anything you can add to that, Andrew?
Going off of Thomas, he likes to run us, but he doesn't like other people to know that he runs us. Because like if you let your competition know what you're doing, then they can do it, and then they can be at the same level.
So. Okay, well, the cat's out of the bag now. So, all right. Sorry, Coach Ross. Brett, let me know when you have something else. Who's the toughest player that you've gone against? Can't say teammate. Oh. I'm talking about opposing player. All right, if you can think of someone, sometimes you guys don't know the names of who you're going against, but sometimes you do. Does anyone kind of fit that description, Andrew? Somebody who, like, oh boy, this defender is really giving me a hard time.
First time playing against him was this past Saturday against Homestead. There's a center back who was so physical. Like, whenever Thomas and I got the ball, he just put on our backs, and he was really good. I don't know his name, but he was a really good player. Good.
Okay.
Yeah. I would agree with him, but one conference player that is really good defender is John Carl. He always is just a physical defender and is always on you.
Interesting.
Gives you a hard time.
Good stuff. Again, here with Neenah boys soccer players, Thomas Priest and Andrew Nasser.
Yep. Yes, yeah.
I got it. Okay, Brett, did you have something else from online?
Yeah, we have some folks on Facebook. Michelle Miller Dunning says, go Rockets. Lisa Beyer says, go Rockets and good luck to the guys. Pam Hesser, Gungerich. I don't know if I'm saying that right. Good luck to Neenah. So we've got a crowd watching on Facebook. But here's another chat question. Okay. Alexander Knight for the guys. Who has been the most fun opponent to play in the FEA over the last 3 years?
Okay, boy, that's very specific. Time favorite. The best of your favorite team to play over the last 3 years?
I'd have to say Oshkosh West because this year and last year, was it 2 years ago too?
Yeah.
And 2 years ago, they've always given us a fun game and competitive game.
We've started not us personally, but the past few years that we've been on the team, there's been a rivalry that's been sparked with us and West.
Ah, yeah. West.
Carry on for a few more years. So.
Yeah. Oh yeah, sure. West had the great soccer player. Heredia. Yes. Yep. Good stuff. Interesting stuff. Brett, you have something else?
Left back Jerry is checking in. How good is the team?
He was on the team.
He wants to know how good is the team chemistry this year. Is it still the same as the Visor boys?
It's pretty close.
Yeah, it's close.
We have good chemistry.
Yeah, good chemistry. We can expound on that, actually.
The Visor boys. Yeah.
Visor boys. What makes the chemistry, you guys? Obviously, you have to, anytime you have a mix, you know, there's different personalities on the team. Why do you guys have such a good chemistry? Is it where the seniors are accommodating and respectful, or what would you say?
I think we mix well, and we've also, a lot of the seniors, we've grown up playing soccer together, so we've been close friends ever since. So I think that helps a lot. But we just all have fun together and mix well.
Okay, Andrew.
Yeah, I think just being able to give your teammates a hard time for the good reason and them not taking it like personal.
Sure.
Because everyone's so close, that makes a good team. Yeah. You can talk like honestly and openly with each other.
Good stuff. Interesting. Brett, you have something else too?
Bim, am I saying that right? I'm not sure if I'm reading that right. But anyway, he wants to know who scored the best goal this season.
Ooh, the best goal this season.
There's been a lot. I'd have to watch the film.
I don't know. There's been a lot of good ones.
There's too many to single out there, Brett, in that way. Brett, let me ask a question here before we go back to online. Again, we talked about your program. There's always younger kids coming up, soccer players at the middle school level, elementary level maybe even. You guys started out there as well. What advice would you give to those young future Rockets that are going to kind of carry the flame for you guys? Because, you know, success is expected of you and it's expected of them when they reach your level. What advice would you give them, Andrew, to a young player?
Thomas and I were lucky to get on the team as freshmen, but like you soon realize that you're not going to right away be at the top. So we didn't get so much playing time as freshmen, even sophomore, but you got to work your way up, and senior year I'll come. That's
okay.
And your playing time will come and everything.
Yeah.
But I would also say just keep working hard and like focus. If you want to achieve something, just focus on it because the time you put in will pay off in the end.
All right, good stuff here again. Brett, do you have something else from online? If not,
well, you might have touched on this one, but Andrew Watt wants to know or says, we all know you guys have the best defense in the state, but how does having Ethan Koons and Bryce Henderson contribute to the team? So some more, they want some more love.
Boy, the defense really needs you guys to talk about them, so I'm going to let you guys talk about them. But, yeah, one of the top defenses in the state, and you're going to need them, obviously, in the semifinals and the finals possibly on Saturday. So, first off, talk about them a little bit, but then how does that kind of, obviously in soccer, one feeds into the other many times. We'll start here with Andrew again. How does that all work together?
They're just bricks in the back. I'd like to see someone body Ethan Koons. You're not able to. And Bryce outpace him. That's not happening. So with the combination of those two, that's crazy.
Or jump higher than anyone.
Yeah.
Okay.
They're good in there.
They're just beasts. Yeah.
And like I think our defense was really good last year too. Mm-hmm. So I think a lot of people thought we wouldn't be as good back there. So I think they really stepped up and did a great job.
Okay, interesting stuff. Did you have something else, Brett?
Here's a real good one from Joel Olson, putting the guys on the spot. Who is the team MVP?
Thomas is that.
I don't know.
I can answer that.
Andrew? Think that there's a consensus among the team?
Yeah.
Okay, all right. There's nothing wrong with that. Thomas, it's okay to be humble. I mean, if you're one of the top players, it's okay. Brett, you have something else?
Nope.
No, guys, I want to talk about the other two teams. Again, you haven't faced Eau Claire before. You don't know anything about them. Verona, Kosnostra, Tremper, is that kind of the same thing? You guys don't really know too much about them?
Yeah.
Wow, so all the teams kind of, they might know each other, but in terms for you, they're kind of new faces. So that's kind of cool. A little bit broader thing with Eau Claire Memorial, is that a good thing knowing that no one knows you guys down there? That's good, right?
Yeah, I guess so. That is good.
They can't really have a game plan against us, so we'll just play our game and that'll work, hopefully.
All right, good stuff. Well, we're going to wrap it up here. We got some shout-outs coming. Brett, do you have anything else from
just post-high school plans.
Okay, yeah, post-high school plans. Who is going on where? Do you guys have anything determined in terms of, I know it's early. Usually you don't do it until you get to college, but sometimes you have a good idea of what you're going to do in college. Thomas, do you have anything squared away?
I'm planning on going to Marquette to play soccer and for school.
Okay. And do you have anything academic-wise secured?
No.
Okay. You have time.
Marquette for soccer.
Well, I meant in terms of any specific
study.
No. Okay. You got time. Mm-hmm. How about for you, Andrew?
Engineering somewhere. I just sent my applications a week ago. So.
Okay.
Yeah.
Let that develop.
Yeah.
All right. Good stuff. Okay. So let's do some shout outs. Rosie, show them the camera that they'll be looking at. Okay. There we go. I always start farthest over to my right. So Thomas, go ahead. Look at the camera and send some love out to people who got your today.
Shout out to my mom and dad, Nancy and David, for putting in so much time. All my siblings for coming to my games, my grandparents, and basically all my family and all my friends that support me.
Okay, great stuff. Andrew?
Shout out to my parents, too. They've done so much for me. Amy and Nader and Megan, my sister. And big shout out to Andrew and Michael. They've just been so good this season, just hyping all the soccer games up and everything. And shout out to Maya, too.
Okay, smart man. All right, good stuff. Hey, can I do a shout out quick? Mine goes out to Coach Russ. I'm going to tell you why, because this is a state week. I know you guys are busy, game playing and stuff. It's the biggest week of your lives coming up here. Thank you so much for letting me have the guys on the show. I know it's a big week, and I want you guys to be comfortable and all that kind of stuff and not have to worry about outside influences. But to be on the show really means a lot to me. All right, Brett, have something from
I want to squeeze this one in from Andrew Watt. He asks, how good was Ian Bogan's save against Homestead on the upper 90 shot?
Okay, there we go. Describe
explain
it, guys.
That.
The ball comes out. It was like close to half field. That center back that I was telling you about earlier takes a big touch. It was still from so far out, and he hits it so cleanly. I just watched it in slow motion.
It was going right up there, and then Ian just comes out of nowhere.
Yeah. Just palms it.
Wow. Interesting.
Really
good stuff. Wow.
So you guys thought it was in.
Yeah.
Saved your season.
He did.
Interesting. Yeah. Give him a shout out. Yeah. Great stuff. Good stuff here. Well, guys, here's the deal. I'm covering state volleyball. I might be down there for the championship if you guys, if things break right. I don't know what's going to happen. We're going to have someone there. Here's the thing. What would have to, let's say you guys are in the championship game, you guys are pulling down that gold championship trophy. What would have had to have happened, I guess? So give me some big keys that you guys are looking for heading into the tournament. What had to have happened? So you guys had to do some things really well. What would those things be? We'll start over here again with Thomas.
probably score early, score lots of goals, and don't give up any goals, which we're good at.
That's a pretty good formula. I like that one. Okay, Andrew?
We just got to get the nerves out somehow. I don't know how we're going to do it, but we got to get the nerves out, and you got to get the hype, the excitement in. Yeah, and that'll set us up for success.
Okay, good stuff. Well, I appreciate you guys being on the show. Again, Thomas Priest and Andrew Nasser.
Yep.
Oh, yeah, I'm on a roll here. Thank you so much for being on the show. We hope that you guys bring home that championship goal, because it's been a while for Neenah. It's been, 10 years now, right, since you guys have brought home that trophy. So good luck to you guys. Stay warm down there at U-Line, a great venue to play soccer. Again, next week we're hoping to have either some volleyball players on, depending on if they win a state championship or if not. But I'm thinking we're probably going to have football players on because it's entering the state semifinal level. Best place to check that out, facebook.com/varsityroundtable. You guys are fans of the Varsity Roundtable on Facebook, aren't you? Or do you guys even have a Facebook account?
No,
okay. Well, for those of you who aren't, please check us out on Facebook at Post Crescent. Or facebook.com/VarsityRoundtable. Till then, everyone, have a great week. Again, for Thomas, for Andrew, for Brett Christofferson and Jim Rosedick, I'm Ricardo Arguello. Again, for the Varsity Roundtable, everyone, have a great week, and we'll see you back here again for another edition of the Varsity Roundtable.